Ladies and gentlemen, the chief guest has arrived, and we kindly request you to stand when the chief guest enters the auditorium. The chief guest, Mr. Lalit Veerathunga, secretary to His Excellency the President. Guest of honor, Mr. Gotabaya Rajapaksa, secretary to the Ministry of Defence and Urban Development. Mr. Karunathilaka Amunugama, secretary to the Ministry of External Affairs. Mr. Subramanian Swami, member of parliament and leader of the Janata Party and a dear friend of Madalanka. Excellencies of the Diplomatic Corps, Chief of Defence Staff, General Jagat Jayasurya, Commander of the Sri Lanka Army, Lieutenant General Daya Ratnayake, Commander of the Sri Lanka Navy, Vice Admiral Jayanath Kolambage, Commander of the Sri Lanka Air Force, Air Marshal Harsha Abevikrama, Past Service Commanders, Director General Civil Security Department, Rear Admiral Ananda Piris, distinguished guests and invitees, guest speakers and delegates from overseas and Sri Lanka, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Defence Seminar 2013. We are honored by your presence and in partnership with you, look forward to a learning and interactive experience which epitomizes the spirit of this seminar. Being a nation founded on a rich culture of almost 2,500 years, it is imperative that this seminar be declared open on a traditional note with the lighting of the traditional oil lamp. And to do the honors, I cordially invite the chief guest, Mr. Lalit Veerathunga, secretary to His Excellency the President. Guest of honor, Mr. Gotabaya Rajapaksa, secretary to the Ministry of Defence and Urban Development. Mr. Karunathilaka Amunugama, secretary to the Ministry of External Affairs. Chief of Defence Staff, General Jagat Jayasurya. Commander of the Army, Lieutenant General Daya Ratnayake. Commander of the Navy, Vice Admiral Jayanath Kolambage. Commander of the Air Force, Air Marshal Harsha Abevikrama, Director General Civil Security Department, Rear Admiral Ananda Piris. Ladies and gentlemen, we continue in tradition with the puja dance. Puja dance is a dance which pays homage to Saraswati, the goddess of art and dance. A unique feature of this dance is that it blends the upcountry and lowcountry styles of dancing. And to perform this dance, we invite the Sri Lanka Army cultural troupe. Ladies and gentlemen, the puja dance. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe a little introduction to the history of Defence Seminar is quite in order. Defence Seminar is the brainchild of the Secretary of Defence, and it began in year 2011, in which we took to the world, we shared with the world our experiences in defeating terrorism. Now, this was from a genuine desire to support other nations too who had the same problem. Inspired by the success of Defence Seminar 2011, we decided to take to the world the post-conflict recovery and the role the army played in post-conflict recovery. And in 2013, under the theme Post-Conflict Sri Lanka Challenges and Regional Stability, we widened the scope and expanded the discourse to include the effects of our recovery on regional stability. Ladies and gentlemen, in order to commence today's proceedings, I will respectfully invite to the stage the Chief Guest, Mr. Lalit Veerathunga, Secretary to His Excellency the President, Guest of Honor, Mr. Gotabaya Rajapaksa, Secretary to the Ministry of Defence and Urban Development, Mr. Karunathilaka Amunugama, Secretary to the Ministry of External Affairs, and Commander of the Sri Lanka Army, Lieutenant General Daya Ratnayake. Ladies and gentlemen, it's customary that the host of the seminar deliver the welcome address. And I consider it an honor to introduce the host and the commander of the army, Lieutenant General Daya Ratnayake. Lieutenant General Daya Ratnayake assumed office as the 20th commander of the army on August 1st, 2013. He was enlisted as an officer cadet to the regular force of the Sri Lanka Army on 6 February 1980 and commissioned into the Sri Lanka Light Infantry Regiment, the oldest regiment of the Army, as second lieutenant on 18 July 1981. In addition to a number of courses followed in reputed military institutions, he has graduated from the Defence Services and Staff College of Bangladesh and the National Defence University of China. In a career spanning more than 33 years, he has attended and contributed immensely to many seminars, conferences, workshops, and invited assignments both locally and internationally. He is presently reading for a PhD at the Kothalawala Defence University. Blending wide experience and service, Lieutenant General Daya Ratnayake has held many command appointments, including command in office of an infantry battalion, and commander of 3 infantry brigades prior to being appointed as the general officer commanding 2-3 infantry division, which spearheaded the historic humanitarian operations in the east. On successful conclusion of the humanitarian operations, he was appointed as the commissioner general of rehabilitation and tasked to rehabilitate 12,000 ex-combatants. Employing a mix of unique concepts and experts, both military and civilian, he initiated a rehabilitation program which was not only successful but also much admired and accepted internationally. He has also held key staff, instructor, and administrative appointments, including commanding of the Sri Lanka Military Academy, director media of the Sri Lanka Army, and military spokesman for the Ministry of Defense during the period from September 2004 to September 2005. His outstanding leadership in combat inspired the success of the humanitarian operations in the critical eastern province, which resulted in the separation of the LTT from its much-needed recruits. Lieutenant General Daya Ratnayake spent a good part of his career leading men in combat, which he did with utmost dedication and valor, sustaining injuries in the process. He has been in the forefront of all major combat operations conducted by the Sri Lanka Army since 1981. His excellent career also includes valuable service to the Sri Lanka Light Infantry and the Military Intelligence Corps. Lieutenant General Daya Ratnayake's distinguished service and valor in combat has earned him more than 20 gallantry and service medals, including Veera Vikrama Vibhushana, Ranavikrama Padakkama, which he has received 4 times. Ranasura Padakkama, 4 times. Uttama Seva Padakkama, for distinguished conduct. And Deshaputra Sammane, for being wounded in combat. Lieutenant General Ratnayak, a keen athlete since his early days, has very successfully pursued the same in the army and carved a niche for himself as both sportsman and sports administrator. In addition to have represented the army in athletics and rugby football, he has actively steered the army sports towards success for the past several years. Moreover, he held the office of the Chairman Defence Services Games Committee in 2011 and 2012, while serving as President of Sri Lanka Armed Sports Control Board since 2010. To his credit, he was unanimously elected to the office of the National Chairmanship of the Sri Lanka Athletics Federation in 2012 and worked tirelessly towards its development. He also represented the Sri Lanka Army in rugby football, for which he was awarded Army Colours. In the year 2005, he was appointed as Deputy Chairman, Army Rugby Committee, and currently serves as a Council Member of the Sri Lanka Army Rugby Union. He has been serving as Chief of Staff of the Sri Lanka Army since January 10, 2010, and is credited with streamlining the administrative and logistic structure of the Army. Lieutenant General Daya Ratnayaka, a distinguished product of Maliyadeva College, Kurunagal, is married to Priyadarshini Damayanti and blessed with 2 sons and a daughter. Ladies and gentlemen, I respectfully invite the Commander of the Army, Lieutenant General Daya Ratnayaka, to welcome this August gathering.